Humans are forgetful, and we need constant reminders of where we've been, what God has carried us through, and just the truth about who God is. In the scripture, we can look at the story of the Israelites and their journey and how often they saw God's miracles. They were in awe. They were all in for his plan and his will. And then time passed. They got distracted. They forgot about the miracles. They forgot about who God is. Like when Moses went to Mount Sinai, he left the Israelites to go up there to talk to God. And God gave him the covenant with Israel and the Ten Commandments. And the Israelites were worried. They got antsy. They didn't know where Moses went, and they didn't know when he was going to come back. And what did they do? They made a golden calf, and they forgot God's plan. Or think about all of the strong leaders we have in the Old Testament. We've got Abraham, Isaac, David, and the list goes on. And they all started their leadership, their ministry with this fire. But then time went on, they got distracted, and that light went out, and they forgot God. There are two stories that I specifically want to dig into this morning, and I'm going to start here in Exodus 14, 21 through 22. So this is when Moses is leading the Israelites out of Egypt, out of slavery, and into the Promised Land. And this is specifically when God, through Moses, performs a miracle, and he divides the Red Sea. So again, this is Exodus 14, 21 through 22. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord drove the sea back by a strong east wind all night and made the sea dry land, and the waters were divided. And the people of Israel went into the midst of the sea on the dry ground, and the waters being a wall to them on their right hand and on their left. And I don't know about you guys, but if I was there in the middle of the Red Sea with a wall of water on either side of me witnessing that miracle, I mean, that would have changed everything. All of my fears, my anxiety, my doubts would have just melted away. And for the rest of my life, I would have looked back on that moment, and that would have been enough to keep my faith strong. And you'd think, right, that it would be the same for the Israelites, but
right.
They wandered through the desert. They got hungry. They got distracted. They got tired. And they forgot God again. And again, going into future, going on a little bit in our story here, Moses dies and Joshua leads the Israelites. And again, they are going to the Promised Land. They are still on that journey. And in Joshua 4, 21 through 24, again, they are met with a body of water. They're at the Jordan River, and they need to go across it. And God performs another miracle, but this time through Joshua. And so God commands Joshua to put the Ark of the Covenant into the water, and that causes the water to disperse. And again, they are walking through it. So they are in the middle of the Jordan River on dry ground once again, and God tells Joshua to tell the 12 leaders of the 12 tribes to stop in the middle of the miracle and to pick up a stone and take it home. And a few verses later, it tells us why God asked them to do that. And it says, "And he said to the people," he being Joshua, "when your children ask their fathers in times to come, 'What do these stones mean?' then you shall tell your children and let them know, 'Israel passed over this Jordan on dry ground, for the Lord your God dried up the waters of the Jordan for you until you passed over, as the Lord your God did to the Red Sea, which he dried up for us until we passed over, so that all the peoples of the earth may know that the hand of the Lord is mighty, that you may fear the Lord your God forever.'" That the hand of the Lord is mighty. God didn't want them to forget again. They were in the middle of a miracle, and he said, "Hold on, wait, look down, look around. This is a miracle. Take this stone as a physical reminder of what I did that day." And they went on, and they told generations to come about what God did, and I just think that's so beautiful, and it's such a great thing to do. And I think if this story has taught me anything, it's taught me that I just need to remember, I need to not allow myself to get distracted by life, to get stuck in the day-to-day actions and things that I have to do and commitments, but just not to allow myself to forget. Not to forget how good and gracious my God is, how powerful my God is, where I was, what he brought me through, and where he is taking me. So the takeaway here, I think, for all of us, is we just need to remember. And I think there's two practical ways that we can do that. The first one being to create daily rhythms of reading scripture, of praying, and of worship. I think prioritizing that time with God can really refocus our lives and keep our perspectives straight. We don't want to get distracted. We don't want to focus on things that are a waste of time. We just want to prioritize God and his mission for us. And two is to put little reminders of God's goodness in your life. And this might look like a reminder on your phone or a sticky note on the mirror in your bathroom or a note card on your dashboard in your car. But things in your life, fill your space, fill your life with these reminders of God's goodness, of his grace, of his patience, and everything that he has done in your life. Just look back and think, wow, my God is so good. And don't forget that, because when we forget, we are lost. We wander. We don't know what we're doing. But have those physical reminders and those things that just keep your focus on God. I just don't want you to forget how good your God is.